Sir, we made a chatbot, and sir, we tried to make it with an API, but sir, unfortunately, we couldn't do it. That's why, sir, we used a corpus file, sir, where we tried to put as much data as possible. And sir, we have also used one image here in this project, sir. Sir, I'm running the code and showing it to you. Like, sir. Sir, this is our chatbot. So for example, I am typing hi and pressing the send. So it will tell us hello. And now, sir, for example, if I want to clear the data, I can simply press over here to clear the data. Mm-hmm. So once again, I am pressing hi. Now, sir, for example, I want the COVID related data. So for example, I am typing Andaman. So I think it has got some issues. Yeah. Sir, just a minute, sir. Sir, I feel the corpus has got some issues. That's why it's not showing the data right now. Sir, the data which we have used over here in the code itself, that was actually working. Like, for example, if we use these greetings like hello, hi, greetings and all these, then it can show us the responses like these. But I feel there's a problem with the corpus. Actually, sir, it was working. Sir, can I please talk with my team members once?
Yeah.
With cases in different states of India. To work with a chatbot, at first we have imported all libraries. At first we have imported imported Tinder, which will help us to create a GUI, which is a graphical user interface. Now, after that, we have imported random, which will help us to generate random information and random replies from the chatbot. After that, we have called NumPy, which is used to work on numerical computation and also used in data science. Now, after that, we have imported NLTK, which can work on the natural language processing, which is very important aspect of chatbot by which we can communicate with the chatbot. Then after that, we have imported Stream. Using this module, all the responses will be applied and also we'll also get the response from the chatbot. After that, we have imported PTI, which will work on the images we have uploaded here. And after that, we have imported sklearn, which will work on the machine learning processor of it. And after that, we have imported vectorizer, which will find the, which will count the number of which will count the frequency of words. And after that, we have imported cosine similarity, which will check the range of the numbers. Now moving ahead with the chatbot, main code of the chatbot. In first few lines, we have given the title of the chatbot, which is this line. We have given the title of the chatbot, and this line of the code will give a proper geometry of the chatbot. And then after that, we have used a corpus by using this line. We are calling the corpus. We have used this txt file to import all the cases, the COVID cases. Now after that, we have converting it into a raw data. Then after that, we have converting it into tokenizing it, and after that we'll collect the data and it will help the chatbot to respond. Here we have done lemonization, and after that we have done we have taken few inputs of greeting. For example, if we say hello, the chatbot will reply hi or hi, no, hi there. These will be the responses we get from the chatbot.
Very good presentation by Nichar and Nilatri. Those who can present will get the full marks, any part of it. So please try to present your project. Next.
Yes, sir, we would like to present.
Yes, sir, Risha will present now.
Okay. Yes, sir.
And everybody should part of it, okay? Yes, sir. Risha.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So can I leave?
Risha has done. Okay.
I think the screen is presented.
Achha, others who can be there, please stay. So this is a learning process. Though if you have No time, you can leave. Others are welcome. Okay. All are welcome.
Yes.
You don't have to leave. Oh. Okay, first initial. Any PPT you have done, Rishabh?
No, sir. No PPT is there.
Okay, at least tell beforehand.
Yes. So we have done the COVID tracker. We are tracking the number of cases, death case and everything in the different countries. But the thing we have modified is that now it not only presents the data. It
can you make your camera on? Can you make your camera on? Those who can speak, make camera on. Yeah. Thank
camera.
You.
If I switch on the camera, the presentation.
Okay. Understood.
Okay. And now it has also the graph facility, so it can track the total number of cases from April 2020 to all over. That is till now. So let me enter the data.
Rishabh, your full name is?
Rishabh Mukherjee.
Okay.
It will take some time because two websites are there. Yes. So now you can see this is the number of cases, coronavirus cases, deaths and recovered. And this is the graph. If you can see that the peak is around July and now the cases are has decreased and now it's still a bit increasing in January 2022.
Is it deaths or is it cases? No, it's the cases.
Cases, total number of cases.
But night time should peak. Okay, I'll wait. Okay.
Actually, it's slightly peaking actually. But
Okay.
So the code will be explained by all our teammates.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I will give a basic like algorithmic overview of the.
Can you make your camera on if it's possible?
Sir, actually, I'm on PC, so.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, sir. Sir, at first we are importing all the different classes and libraries that we are going to need, and then we have broken down each aspect of the project and assigned it to the different methods, and then we call the function from the main method as required, so that like at the same time we can perform more than one operation. Also, we can easily perform the same operation more than once without repeating the code.
Got it.
So at first we have this method in which we extract the data from a website using its URL. Then we return this data to the point where it is called from. In the next function, we are taking the worldwide.
Can you please explain the why you request the import request? Like all others many might not know, I have not done in the class. So please explain import request, import BS4, import TK Intel. Okay, I have done it in the class. If you can. Okay, import pandas I also done in the class, but import matplotlib I have done. So can you briefly explain, or anybody, Rishabh or who else, can explain import request, import BS4? Thank you. Devrin, are you getting my point? Are you getting
Sir,
my
can point? You repeat the question?
I think not a question at all. You just explain the codes, like why you have done import request. What does this line do? Import BS4, what this line do? Can you explain?
Sir, actually this request and linker are already inbuilt libraries, which are actually codes, and they actually help.
Okay. For what?
Yes, sir.
Like import TK Intel for GUI,
yes, sir.
Import pandas is for the pandas library. What is for import request?
For the requests, it sends a request to the website for an
sir, actually, link. We are using our website along with Python code. So,
okay.
In order to link our Python code with the HTML part, so we are using request.
Okay.
So, these are actually modules which we are importing in order to get the functions of those modules into our own program.
Okay.
They are like just,
sure.
they are like functions that we have written, get COVID detail BD. So those functions
okay.
Already written in, so we are importing those things.
Okay, actually. Good. Carry on, Devlina.
Yes, sir. Sir, in the second function, that is the get COVID detail, in that one, we are taking the worldwide data from the website, and then we are printing that one in the default screen.
Mm-hmm.
And in the next function, please scroll down. Yes, in the get country data, in this function, we are taking the name of the country in the text field, and then we are extracting the data from that website accordingly.
Okay.
Also, in this function, we are also including a graph using the matplotlib, which helps us to track the number of cases in the country the increase or decrease over time. And after that, we have also a reload function. Scroll down, please. Yes, this reload function, and this is activated when we click the reload button. And in the main part, we have created a graphical user interface using Tinkter. And here we are also defining the aspects and the buttons of the window which is coming. And then we use root.mainloop to loop the program after every time. Yes, and now my teammates will explain the code. Sure. Line by line.
Okay. And very good, Devlina, you have done. Rishabh also done. When you explain that others do not know at all. In fact, you take it as I do not know a Python, or I am just a learner of Python. You explain it, so it will be recorded and it will be visible to you. Okay, carry on. Who is the next speaker?
Also me, Momita.
Momita, yeah, please carry on.
Yes, sir. So in this Devlina, board,
your full name? Momita, your full name?
So Devlina
Momita Boshak.
Okay.
So in the first part of the code, we are importing packages like BS4 requests, TK enter as TK and plier time, date and time, pandas, mat, plot, LIB, etc. So now the code is divided into two parts. The first part is basically loading the data of the current death cases and recovered, and the second part is loading the graph of the dates.
Okay.
Here we are importing a lot of packages. Then we are using data analytics. We are importing pandas, MATLAB, so here we are, as we are using the graph, actually the graph is the form of particular time to another particular time period. Like first we are request for getting the data from the particular URL that will be passing through from this code. Then we are using BS4 code to beautify the HTML cases. Then we'll be uses tkinter holographic data user interface and different packages for all the different things, time and date and time. Next, we are calculating the data the graph part. First part of the code, we are defining the method of HTML data. Then we are requesting to get the HTML. Then we are giving the URL of the particular website, which is a coronavirus official website. So here is the URL. Then from the data, what we are doing, we are just web scraping using web scraping. Then we are going to the website and we check the inspect, and then we see what part we want to script in our documents. So that's it.
Very good. Very good, Momita. Okay. Anybody can, Rishabh, is this complete? Your group has, everybody is there or anybody else is there?
Yeah, sir, actually, me, Rishabh, Momita have already given Viva for TSM, sir. Okay.
Okay, very good.
Okay,
yeah, it is no issue. It is all welcome. So, because in a project presentation, it is a Viva come project. So, you are most welcome. So, the very good presentation. So, I just ask of you, are you happy with your project, or what can be done for this project?
I think, sir, it's quite nothing more can be done, because as you saw, when I entered the data and I clicked decade data, it took quite a bit of time. It took around 2.5 to 3 seconds, and that's for a country, India, which is
okay. Prominent. Okay, 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 I got your point. Who has done Moichu, and I think the Nilabji and Nidja, they are not there.
Sir,
I
am there. Moichu
is there. Moichu is there. Moichu, You have done with Nilaji project or here?
No, sir. I just explained
me,
about
Moitra.
Those Tinker and.
Oh, Moitra is here.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
I just explained about those modules and all.
Okay. Very good. No issue, because we have already given Viva. You can.
I will describe the reload function.
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. Rishabh, can you please take it to there? Okay, so the reload function, it is basically the function of a reload sign that we usually have at the top of the page in Chrome, and it's similar, but here we have just like after we are having a number of cases, we reload the page to get some new information at that exact point of time. So the reload function works exactly like that. Next, we go on to the portion where it defines the graphical user interface part of the entire data, like the COVID-19 update, as we can see, is the window name. So it's here written that it is COVID-19 update, and all the specifications that we have seen, like the font size, the size of the writing, and the point from where we have taken all the pictures, and the data has been taken. All these are given in this graphical user interface part. So we have created instance of the Tinker package that we have imported as root, and then using root.geometry, I have decided the dimensions of the page. Then we have decided the title and the font and the photo image, all these and afterwards it's all the same. Like we have taken the data and all the important titles. So with this, I would say that. And Rishabh, move it a bit down.
Yeah.
Yes, and then root.main loop, so that we can have it again.
Very good.
Thank you, sir.
Very good. Very good. Thank you. Actually, what I wish to tell, because you are in that right now in the second year, but you should be able to an web app and also an Android app. So what are the rest things? Most of this, see, 70 to 80% work is already done. So you should be able to do it in a web app. Web app means it will work from your any website, and you should be making a web app, or better is an Android app with the help of JavaScript as a front end, back end is a Python and Django or this thing as a your framework. So that we start, but very good work. But you please continue this kind of work, because why you are using Python? Because it should work in everywhere. It should not stick with your computer. So this work should be available maybe your personal blog site. So everybody should have your personal blog and GitHub account, and if it is working from your GitHub, please upload it there. So very good work. Thank you. So please continue this kind of work.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Next,
we will get good marks too.
So full marks will get, those who can present will get 20 out of 20. I generally give full marks. Okay.
Somebody SMC took our Viva, you will give 20.
You talk with SMC. Next, please.
Sir, then my Viva is done. I'm Devchita, sir.
Yeah, your Viva is given, you have got 20 marks. Everybody who can present got full
okay, sir,
marks.
Sir, I'm stopping. And,
yeah, thank you.
Sir, can you present next?
Yes.
Sir, actually, our team members Niladri and Nirjal presented our project. Sir, I was actually okay. presenting in
yeah,
the.
Yeah, please. You please. Your name is Harsh. Harshita.
Yes,
just please note your name to give you 20 marks.
Sir, I Neha Raj also live from the group.
This group? Neha?
Yes, sir.
Okay, show your project.
Sir, I will be sharing the PPT.
Okay. So who will present now, Harshita or Neha?
Sir, I will present the code.
Okay.
And the output also, sir.
So who are the team members, Neha and Harshita together?
No, sir. Neha, myself, Harshita, and Nirjhar, Mrigangko, and Niladri.
Okay. So Harshita, please, Neha, please wait. Let Harshita finish, then I'll start. Okay, Neha.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Sir, I'm presenting Sir, is my screen visible?
Yeah, it's visible.
Yes, sir. So, sir, this was the code. And firstly, I will be showing the output and then I'll explain the code a little bit.
Okay.
Sir, I have run because our project has a little bit of demerit that firstly, if we enter the name of a country to know the data of the country, it takes a little bit more time now. Like for now, it takes a little bit more time. Otherwise, our project chatbot was based on basically a corpus, which was a resource file, I could say, from where the chatbot works and finds out data what the user asks.
Okay.
So if we are giving the country as a question to give the data of the current data of the country, then it takes a little time. But otherwise, if I say anything like hi or anything related to what I know, what I want to know from it, like related to COVID thing, then I would get it in a second only. But actually, we are having currently a problem with the country only. So I will show 1 second. Yes, sir. I entered education. So this was showing that I entered the education, and the bot is saying methods and all this. And these all texts are coming from a notepad file, which is acting as a corpus for the whole chatbot. And otherwise, if I say, like, for example, if I'm saying, like, who are you? Then it will show. I am Dr. Zen. Actually, we have created a chatbot like this only. And wow. So for now, I will explain some coding part.
Sure.
Sir, this COVID.txt is showing that what is the file that we have, that is the chatbot is working upon. And this send token and word token part will be explained more by Neha, sir, because this was the part of tokenization in which the sentences are broken into smaller units for the chatbot to work.
Okay.
And this was a list which I created that if the user enters something between this, the chatbot responses will be something between, the chatbot will show something random from this list only.
Okay.
For the greetings part. And then the response part, all these parts are, sir, basically on the part of machine learning. These are a little complex part of these are using the vectorizer concept and all. And this is the country part that if I when we are entering any country, for example, if we enter India, we are taking the data from a website. So the other part are working with a corpus, but if there is a country name, it is working with the website. So these all parts are from the website only. And it helps us to get the data from this website, opendata.ecdc website. And then, so these are the part of
What is JSON, Harshita? Mention it was JSON. JSON.
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, I'm not sure about it, sir.
Okay, carry on. No issue.
So then these are the parts which are like pre-inter part of designing part.
Okay.
And so the main part of the code is here. That is the it concatenates what the user enters. And then it is like checking condition. If the user enters something related to greeting part, then the greet function works. And if the user enters bye, then then the bot will show thank you for having a conversation. And after some time, that is 2000 milliseconds, the program will destroy. And these are the basically, sir, conditions.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Very good. So, if you want to continue, then Neha can take over.
Yes, sir. So this was the part, but only demerit here is that what I told about country, but it takes a little more time.
Okay. After exam, you can try to improve it and make it try to Android app and web app. Okay. So you can learn how to make an Android app.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. Neha?
Okay,
can
sir. Okay, sir, I'm presenting.
Okay.
So the screen is visible,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it is visible.
Okay, sir. So we were working on the project which was related to Python, and we have done the project for chatbot using Python. And these are some basic applications using which we can it is widely used in exercise coaching, nutrition counseling, and also it is used in order tracking, purchase assistance, and there are a lot of applications of chatbots. Then talking about the architecture of chatbots, so I'm starting with the architecture of chatbots. So it consists of a window, then after window it comes interface, and then NLP model, which is a natural language processing model, and then it relates to corpus and application DB. DB is the database. Then it involves data processing, and in data processing it converts all the data which is coming in as an input, either upper or lower case. Then data pre-processing also used for avoiding misrepresentation and misinterpretation of words if split under lower or upper cases. Then we also use tokenization, which is a structured process of converting a sentence into individual collection of words. Then it consists of stemming, which is a process of finding similarities between words with the same root words. Then it contains a bag of words, BOW, and this is a process in which we do process of converting words into numbers by generating vector embeddings from the token which we have already generated. Then comes a factor, one hot encoding, and it is a process by which categorical variables are converted into a form that machine learning algorithm uses. So this is the bibliography, means these are some sources from where we have taken help for making this PPT. And
very good presentation.
Okay,
thank you group. Very good presentation, thank you.
Okay.
Next, anyone?
Can I present next?
Yeah. One at a time, please.
Sir.
Who is presenting?
Sir,
Ishi. Okay. Ishi, what's the full name?
Sir, Ishi Sarkar.
Ishi Sarkar, okay.
Ishika, can you present?
Yes.
Ishi and Ishika, both are there, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Ishika, full name?
Sir, Ishika Pine.
Ishika Pine, okay, thank you. Please, carry on. Anyone of you can make your camera on? Is it possible?
Sir, if the network is very weak.
Okay.
Sir, we have seen most of our friends have worked on the COVID tracker. They are tracking the number of COVID cases. So we thought we should also do something with the vaccines. Now the vaccines have come, so we are doing a vaccine availability checker. Here, if we use up the area codes, we are accessing the available vaccines of that area. And so this will help in the creating, we can increasing the vaccination. So, sir, now
okay.
Ishika will explain about the code.
So, if we run this code, then we have to give the PIN code. For example, I'm giving this PIN code and I'm giving a date. So if I click on find, I will get the center's name along with the age group and vaccine available.
Okay.
And also, and it goes for same for other PIN codes also. So, sir, will I show it for other PIN codes?
Yeah. Can you show me the our college PIN code? College PIN code, I think. Can you show me my PIN code? 700055?
Yes, sir.
700055? Yeah.
So it is telling it has not arrived.
Okay, so I think college pin code is 134, I believe. 134, 135.
So I will give the college pin code.
Yeah, yeah. 700135.
So it is showing this center.
Okay, very good. Okay, very good. Any other pin code can you try? It's working. Okay, can you show me the pin code of 7405?
Yes, sir.
7405.
So it is showing the centers.
Very good. Very good. But doses are not available. Okay. Carry on.
Yes, sir. First, we have imported the modules, this tkinter module and date time request, PYTZ. And after that, we have created the geometry for the window user, graphical user interface. And in here, we have given the geometry as well as the title. And then we have given the color references of the background, and here we have given the details of the frames in the graphical user interface, and we have created the labels for different date, current time, pin code, and so on. And then again we have created the entry boxes to enter the pin code as well as the date. And
game's name is Hangman. It's a very basic game which is mostly taught to elementary kids to expand their vocabulary. So first of all, we make a word file, which is words.txt, and read it. After reading it, we split it into an array and choose a word at random. After choosing a word at random, we are printing that welcome message, and you have 8 guesses remaining, etc. Now, normally, all the alphabets are available for you, and there are no hints given to you, which we are thinking of later changing. So let's, for example, we are choosing the letter B. Then it's saying that automatically that letter B isn't available in this, and you have 7 guesses remaining. So let's go with a vowel. And whenever we type a letter which is actually present in the word, then automatically it shows each position where the letter is present and shows you have 7 guesses remaining. This way we have to guess until your guesses expire. And then it completely shows what the actual word was. It's a very simple program, and it reads every letter and then searches along the way and prints it at this exact position. Other than that, it's nothing much. We wanted to add a front end to it and a bit more colorful, but because we are only 2 members and we are very...
Yes, actually we are new and a new one in our group.
Okay, carry on the good works. At least yes, anyone else right now is ready?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. I think we have finished.
Yes, sir, it seems like we have finished. So,
okay.
Can we leave?
I am waiting if anybody.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you can go.
Sir?
Yes, please carry on.
Sir, have you noted down our roll numbers?
Yeah, your name is there, that is enough. Your roll number?
Thank you, sir.
Your roll number?
088 last.
Okay.
Thank you.
Fine. Thank you.
Yes.
Please. I think everybody has given. Shilbhadra, Niladri, Navendu, everybody has given Project Fiber. Anyone remaining, I am putting in the group. Can you tell in the group anybody remaining by the, of course, want to show his project?
Sir, here we have used at least 99 to 100 cryptocurrency which are actually available in the market. So here you can see these are some the examples of those cryptocurrencies. Here you can see EOS, Binance Coins, Stellar, etc. And if you see, we have used at least 99 cryptocurrencies. Sir, for this, in this portion, we have tried to show and compare the values of different cryptocurrencies with Bitcoins. So this is the part, and after which we have tried to show the interface, that is the front end, where we have done the front end with the help of HTML and CSS. Here you can see. So sir, it's a long project, and at this time we are trying to contact with Prishandu and Kanjo and other members. As their Viva is over, we cannot connect with them. So sir, me and Munjit is present there.
Sir, I am here.
Gustav is present, sir, and this is the part which I have tried to do and explain. Now, sir, Munjit is here, and Munjit will continue with the project.
Oh, Shilvatra, just stop here. Just the next page, please. Oh, go to the first page first. Let's start from there only. Just a little below. So, sir, we tried to track the real-time cryptocurrency here. First, we imported the various libraries like Report, Panda, Time, etc. for the project. Now, a little bit down. Yes, sir. For getting data, we use various... just go to page number 11. Yes, below this, sir. We taken a URL from where we are gathering the informations, which we used 11. Sir, yes, sir. Here is the URL source from where we were gathering the informations from which the real-time tracking will be done. So, as Shilvadro told, we use the HTML and CSS for the front-end part. Once we have completed, we might complete it by February 2nd week. So, if it's completed by then, we can show you the final project. So,
okay. Any code can you show? Code is working? Any portion of code?
Sir, at this moment, nothing is working.
Okay.
At this moment, nothing is working.
Okay. Shilvadro, who are you with?
Sir, Gustav.
I am with Munjit, Gustav, Krishnendu, and Kanchan.
Okay, okay, okay. Please try to run the code. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
I think everybody has given Viva, no? Already to Shuprabhat, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay,
thank you. I think nobody else right now. Okay, thank you. Thank you all. Try to get a good project. It's a good project. So try to get it out.
Yes, sir. We will be completing it by February.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Bye. You can leave back.
Sir, is our part?
Sir, can I present?
Yeah, yeah. Please, yeah. Yeah, you can leave. Who is right now? Who want to present?
Sir, me, Kaushik Das.
Kaushik. Kaushik, you present. A group of Chamaka, sir. Present Kaushik, you should provide such a set. Why did you? Have you given
Viva to
Shuprabhat, sir? As a project, you put it, sir, Kaushik? Come back,
Has
sir. Intelligence. And I am here to assist you in a variety of tasks. As best as I can. 24 hours a day.
Sir, can you hear?
7 days a week.
Yeah,
is now fully operational. Good afternoon, sir.
So,
how may I help you?
So, this is the UI part. And so, I will give instruction using voice. So, what is the time?
What is the time?
Sir, the time is 16 hours, 22 minutes and 58 seconds.
Play music. Who is Amitabh Bachchan?
Searching. According to Wikipedia, Amitabh Bachchan is an Indian actor, occasional playback singer, film producer, television personality, and former politician who works in Hindi films. He made his acting debut in 1969 with Sat Hindustani and narrated Mrinal Sen's Bhuvanshom, 1969.
Open Google. YouTube search Spider-Man. YouTube search Spider-Man. YouTube search. So suddenly it stopped working, but
very good work. Very good.
So can I explain the code?
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. So for the UI part, I have used like PyQt5. So for PyQt5, I have imported all this. So previously, I was like making another file for the GUI, then tried to import it, but it was not working. So I made it into a single program only. So I imported all this. You have seen that I have used that Wikipedia information. So for that, I have imported this Wikipedia, and for the speech part, I have imported PyTTX X3 and speech recognition, and named it as SR. Here you can see.
Okay.
And so main function is like only like if else part. Like in the voice, if I recognize who is or what is, then I will search in the query like and replace the word with Wikipedia. Then results equal to Wikipedia.summary. This is like searching in the database that is presently there in Wikipedia. Similarly, YouTube search also, I will search that in the query. This is the kit that I have used for YouTube search. Simple instructions like open YouTube or open Google, I have used simply webbrowser.openyoutube.com, webbrowser.google.com. And for playing music, I have also included a directory in my file, like local disk C. From that directory only, it will it can do two types of things. That it can also use like random from the directory, or like previously, if we like assign some value to like index to the directory that this song only we want to play, then we can directly include this. And for this is for the time. So you can see, sir, this is the class for the UI. And these are the links that are that I have in the GUI part. I have included many GIFs, moving GIFs. So that's why for opening it in the runtime, I have included in that set pixmap, qtgui.qpixmap. And others are like the written part and their height and width. You can see set text, set scale, all these type of things. And this is the like driving code for the GUI part. When the I will execute the code, then only all the like running GUI window will pop up. And that's all, sir.
Very good. Very good question. It's a very good project. I'm trying to continue in a web app and Android app version. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Very good question. I think I understand. Anyone else is there to present?
This is our project, sir, Mario game. Run it. This is the game.
Okay.
This is the game, sir. This is the game. So this is the code, sir.
Okay.
Import pygame. This is the library function. Next one is to import SYS. Also library. This is pop-up window. Windows with 1200.
Can you show the view once more, please?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Carry on. Describe then. Show the presentation once more. This is what he is doing.
Mario game, sir. It's more.
Okay.
This is the game, sir.
Okay. Okay. Carry on.
This is the output window, sir. And this is input library pygame. Also, second input SYS. This is the library.
Okay.
Output Windows width 1200 and height 600. Okay, sir.
Okay.
This is the color quotation. Yes, sir.
Okay.
This is the image. I am using this game. Actors PNG.
Okay.
This is another picture. This is canvas. This is the code Mario. Further explanation, my friend Riti Kapal. Continue this presentation, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Good afternoon, Ritika. Thank you, Nanda.
Thank you, sir.
Nanda.
So actually, Ritika having some network issue and
Her
laptop is not working.
Okay. No, not working. She can come on mobile phone. Presentation can be done by Narendra. She can
sir, join. Yeah. Sir, actually, our first project is lagging. That's why I am short time to in this project completed, sir.
Okay.
Our previous project was
machine learning project, sir. That is okay, sir.
Show that project.
Okay, sir. Our PC is not capable this code. This is the project, sir, but our PC is not capable to run this project. That's why, sir.
Okay.
Another, that's another project, sir. Live object detection, sir.
Okay. Understood.
Hello, sir.
Tell me, Ritika.
স্যার আমার না খুব প্রবলেম হচ্ছে স্যার, ল্যাপটপ পুরো বন্ধ হয়ে যাচ্ছে, আমি না প্রোগ্রাম কিছু এখনো সাবমিট করতে পারিনি স্যার।
আচ্ছা তুমি এদের কোনো প্রোগ্রামের প্রজেক্টে তুমি বলো কিছু একটা কোড ডেসক্রাইব করে দাও।
স্যার আমার এখনো না ওটা সাবমিট হয়নি স্যার। আমার স্যার ল্যাপটপ বন্ধ ছিল স্যার, আর টাইমও নেই।
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, ওটা তুমি ওটা করে নাও, ঠিক আছে পরে দেখা যাবে।
আমি বন্ধ হয়ে গিয়েছিল স্যার পুরো।
ঠিক আছে, তুমি কলেজে প্রেজেন্ট দেবাশিস স্যার যেটা দেখবেন ওটা করে নাও, ঠিক আছে
স্যার? আমি শো করে দিয়েছি স্যার, এইমাত্র আমি স্যারকে শো করেছি।
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, আদা মডিউলে ওটা সাবমিট করতে হবে।
আর হ্যাঁ স্যার, আমি মডিউলে সাবমিট করছি স্যার।
আচ্ছা তোমার কি শুক্রবার স্যার কাছে ভাইবা দিয়েছো?
নো স্যার।
আচ্ছা তাহলে ঠিক আছে, তাহলে তুমি সাবমিট করে দাও এখানে তুমি প্রজেক্ট। আচ্ছা তাহলে তুমি একটা
কল স্যার, আমি এটা সাবমিট করে আমি এখানে বলতে আসছি স্যার, একটু টাইম দিবেন।
হ্যাঁ না
স্যার, আপকো স্যার আউটপুট শো করা দিয়া দুসরে স্যার কো, আপকো স্যার প্রজেক্ট দেখা দিয়া, অর ভি ভাই বে দেনা হোগা হাম লোগো কো?
নেই নেই, নো নো নাথিং, প্রজেক্ট ইজ এনাফ। নো
স্যার, কেমন কথা স্যার, পহলে স্যার
আপকো কেন কেন প্লিজ ওয়েট ফর রিতিকা এট লিস্ট।
ওকে ওকে,
রিতিকা নিড সাম হেল্প। ওকে
ওকে স্যার। স্যার কেও হয় পতা হে, পহলে জো প্রজেক্ট দিখায়া থা না স্যার আপকো?
ইয়েস ইয়েস।
मेरा जो जीपीयू था वो खराब हो गया, इसलिए सर प्रोजेक्ट नहीं रन कर पा रहा हूँ सर।
वेट सर, आई एम टेनिंग सर। सही नवल ग्रुप वी आर हेल्पिंग सर, हर्ष हर्ष कुमार, हर्ष राज एंड मी एंड इफिका सर। Sir, this is our group, sir. Sir, we have made the weather app, sir.
Ritika, which Ritika?
Sir, Ritika, nahi, sir. Isika, sir. Isika Jaiswal. And Kuan Nipendra, sir.
Isika,
Sir, we have made the weather app, sir.
Send me the project group.
Sir, this one, sir. Good. So the person explain
the code.
I don't know, sir.
Okay, so here we have taken three modules as input, tkinter for the GUI request to process the HTTP request and time for the present date and time. And we've made use of this API, Open Weather App, to tell us the API of that particular place, to get the weather of that particular place we're inputting and the city of it. Turn down, like, scroll. Not so much. So here we have taken the JSON data, like from the API. The data was readable, so we did not need to use the loads function. So we're processing it with request, and we are getting the making use of the API to get the JSON file. And then we are calculating the minimum temperature, maximum temperature, pressure, and humidity with the help of it, and printing it in the final next paragraph, this one. And the next one, the canvas tkinter, is for the GUI, the presentation of it. We are presenting the weather app is written. If we run the output, the dimensions of it is 600 by 500 and the title is weather app. These are the fonts and the font size and all, the text field.
Very good. Anyone to, if you want to more go for this application, Android app in the updated exam? Do you have any other plan? Yeah. You should have planned for some joining some hackathons and all this. So this kind of app development will give you help in your future. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Very good work. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.